Hi, I'm Mike with Lenovo. In this video, I'm going to show the best practices to follow when servicing heatsinks and microprocessors in Lenovo products. There are many types of processors across the different Lenovo systems, and I'm going to cover each one. Tower and small form factor desktop systems use processors that can be removed from a socket and replaced. Most of the time, there will be a heatsink and fan assembly that must be removed to access the processor. First, unplug the fan cable from the system board. The cable is usually nearby, and you can follow the cable from the fan to the plug on the board. You can then remove the heatsink by loosening the four screws. The screws should be loosened using a cross pattern, loosening the first screw halfway, then the next screw diagonally across from it all the way. Then go back and loosen the first screw all the way. Loosen the third screw halfway, then the fourth screw all the way. Then go back and loosen the third screw all the way. Once the screws have all been loosened, you can lift the heatsink out of the system. Most desktop and workstation processors in Lenovo systems are going to have the same type of latch to hold it in place. You want to press down and outward to release the latch, and then open the processor door. Once the door has been opened, you can remove the processor. Be sure to pick it up by the edges and avoid touching the bottom of the processor. When you remove the heatsink and processor, there will be some thermal compound on them. This must be cleaned off and reapplied before reinstalling the components. Place the processor on an anti-static surface and use a cotton swab dipped in isopropyl alcohol or an alcohol wipe to clean the thermal compound. Cleaning the heatsink is the same. Use the alcohol wipes or cotton swabs to get the old thermal compound off. To replace the processor, align the corner of the processor that is marked with a triangle to the corner of the socket that is marked. Most of the sockets will be marked with a triangle, either on the socket itself or on the system board. Some sockets may be marked with something other than a triangle, but there will be a clear mark for one corner on all sockets. Just align the triangle on the processor with that mark and it'll fit correctly. Place the processor in the socket, being careful to avoid touching any of the connections on the bottom of the processor or inside the socket. Close the processor door and press down and inward on the latch to lock it into place. If a new heatsink is being used, thermal compound is generally already applied and you can install it as is. However, if you are reinstalling the old heatsink, thermal compound needs to be applied to the processor before placing the heatsink back into the system. Place a small amount of thermal compound on the center of the processor, about the size of a pea. Applying too much will create a mess when the heatsink is installed, and too little can lead to overheating during use. Place the heatsink on top of the processor using the screw holes for alignment. Tighten the screws using a cross pattern. Tighten the first screw halfway, then diagonally across, tighten the second screw all the way. Then go back to the first screw and tighten it all the way. Go to the third screw and tighten it halfway. Then to the fourth screw and tighten it all the way. Then go back to the third screw and tighten it all the way. Tightening the screws in this manner ensures that the thermal compound will spread evenly across the processor and creates a good connection so the heat can be dissipated. Connect the fan cable to the system board to complete the replacement. There are some Lenovo notebooks in which the processors are installed into sockets, similar to the desktop processors, but most have processors that are soldered onto the system board. The heatsink and fan assembly in one notebook or tablet system may be very different in shape and size from one found in another, but they are generally installed the same way. Disconnect the fan cable from the system board. On some notebook heatsinks, the screws are numbered to show which order is best for removal and replacement. Start by loosening at screw number one, then follow the numbers. Once the screws are all loose, pick up the heatsink and remove it from the system. Some notebooks have embedded graphics processors on the system board. In that case, there will be another set of screws on the heatsink that fasten over the graphics processor. These are sometimes numbered too, but if they are not, you can loosen them with a cross pattern just like the others. Once the screws are all loose, pick up the heatsink and remove it from the system. The processor and heatsink will have thermal compound on them, and this must be cleaned before replacing the heatsink. Use the same technique that was used on the desktop processors, with alcohol wipes or a cotton swab dipped in alcohol. If you have a new heatsink, it may come with thermal compound pre-applied. If you're reusing the old heatsink, you'll need to apply it yourself. Many notebooks have processors that are smaller than those found in desktop systems. You should never need to use more than a pea-sized bead of thermal compound, but you will need to use less than that on systems with smaller processors and smaller graphics processors. Apply a small amount of thermal compound to the processor and graphics processor if there is one. Place the heatsink into position over the processor using the screw holes for alignment. Tighten the screws using the numbered pattern. Tightening the screws in this manner ensures that the thermal compound will spread evenly across the processor and makes a good connection so the heat can be dissipated. And finally, plug the fan cable into the system board. This concludes our video on the best practices for servicing processors and heatsinks in Lenovo systems.